Pope Benedict the 16th has just left the Vatican, boarding a plane for his visit to Australia. He'll arrive in Sydney tomorrow ahead of World Youth Day. Brisbane celebrated this morning with thousands of pilgrims singing and marching through the CBD.
10,000 pilgrims from 40 different countries streaming down Adelaide Street. Young Christians injecting new energy into Catholicism.
Really cool to see the unity of the faith here.
High on life, making new friends in a welcoming city. They'd gathered before 9 a.m, early for teenagers to be this energetic. So many pilgrims, it took five churches of different denominations to fit them in. The founders of St. Stephen's Cathedral could never have imagined this. The faith is changing with the times.
God rules!
Archbishop John Battersby proud to lead the way.
It is a terrific feeling. I wish we could get that crowd every Sunday.
The words didn't matter.
Everyone's so happy. You must feel that.
At the Roma Street Parklands, 15,000 Catholics celebrated.
And as if this isn't big enough, imagine Sydney next week, where World Youth Day is attracting 125,000 international visitors. That's more than the 2000 Olympics.
Brisbane's pilgrims are heading south. The Pope arrives in Sydney tomorrow, where he has a fan in brave young burn survivor Sophie Delisio.
So he's the number one in the world, isn't he?
Yeah. Well, what about God?
Yeah, well, he's straight under God, isn't he?
Jennifer Nichols, 7 News.
And 7 News will have live coverage of the Pope's arrival in Sydney, expected to be at about 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon.
Every nation, every tribe, come together to worship you. In your presence we delight, and we will follow to the ends of the earth. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
worship you. Only one, we worship you. Bread of life, we worship you. Emmanuel, we worship you.
From the Holy Spirit, God.